everybody, it's Martin again. Tonight I'm tying a salmon fly for a change. Thought I'd put a bit of a variety into my channel, so. I'm tying this on a Shumakov long range style tube. So I've just fixed it in the vise. I just used the regroove in the HMH tool to hold the tube securely. Then I'm going to start some, just using 10-aught black Vivus thread. It's quite good, this thread. It's really strong for its diameter. And so for the tail, like this, I'm just going to use some bright yellow yarn. If I was tying a traditional Stoat's tail on a hook, I'd probably go with golden pheasant topping. But on the tube, I feel that this is just a bit nicer, a bit more practical. It fits better. So I'll just get that tied in and folded back. That's it, that's secure, that's going nowhere. Just tighten that a bit more, don't want that twisting. And then to put some kind of taper in, it's nice just to come in and sort of cut it at different lengths. Get a sort of nice tapered effect in the tail. And then just put some Velcro through it to sort of brush the fibres a bit. So that's that, that's tied in securely, it's not going anywhere. I'm going to take a black cock hackle, fairly webby is good. I don't want, you don't want a sort of nice crisp spiky hackle for this. Fold this the stem back and break it away. Now just double the hackle. Give it a couple of turns, two or three. So one, two, three's plenty. Right, and then you just bring your thread up, cross, you know, bend the hackle across the thread at 90 degrees and take a couple of turns, two or three turns to lock it in place. And that stops you, helps stop you trapping any fibres. And it's nice and secure. And then I'll just fold it back because it's quite a thin stem in this. And take two or three turns just to lock it all in place. And just keep your thread tight and snap the stem away because it's nice and clean. So the wing of this fly I'm using Marble Fox, use Arctic Fox, whatever you like really. Arctic Runner's quite nice for these sort of slightly smaller flies. These fox fibres, it's quite important to sort of like clean all the bottom out. If you actually take it, I just like to let my wee Velcro on the lollipop stick. Just take it and pull it through, it gets all the, you can see how much underfur's come out. And I'll do the same at the front just to make sure it's all separate. That sort of opens up your bunch, makes it nice and mobile. And then we'll just taper the bunch slightly to help put some taper into the fly right from the beginning. And this underwing should be a wee bit shorter than the overall, what you're going to end up with overall. So just measure that up. Take a couple of wraps and they're nice. I'm going to put a bit of wax on my thread just for a wee bit of extra security with these. You know, the hairs, you don't want the hairs slipping. And just spread it. Make sure you've got a nice wide footprint. You know, you want the silhouette to be wide, relatively flat vertically, but wide. Horizontally, because that's what the fish see. They don't see it for the side as such, really. If you think about the way that your fly swimming, swinging around in there, coming up and hitting it. So I've just got a couple of strands of yellow angel hair. And folded them over. I like to double synthetics wherever possible. Just sort of use your thumbnail to make sure everything's sitting as you like. Try to avoid creeping forward too much. You'll end up with a big, huge head. So. Then we're ready for another hackle. See if you can find the slightly longer hackle against, you want it nice and webby. You know, it's actually quite a good, these salmon flies are a good way to use up some of the feathers that you might not like for some other streamers. If you're like a palmered streamer, you might feel that you want something a bit crisper. So these are, it's a good way to use these fibres. I'm looking at this, I'm actually going to leave some of the sort of marabou-y stuff on it. I quite like that. At the bottom, the flue. There. So it's just a turn or two. It's just the extra movement. And same as before, fold the stem back and keep your thread tight so you can break it off. Then just wind this hackle just the same, one turn in front of the other, just fold it back with each turn. That's about right, that's fine. Same as before, come up, cross your thread with that 90 degree bend, fold the tip back, three turns, and just, I shouldn't pull you, I shouldn't catch your angel here, snap it away. So, we'll look at it, see how everything's sitting. Looks quite good at this stage. Gap in the hackles. I'm just going to tie back a bit. There we go. The front hackle was just sitting a wee bit too far forward. And you can always, you know, go in and a couple of thread wraps isn't going to do any damage really, and you can manipulate the materials to suit you what you want a bit better. So now I'm going to tie in the the final wing, the second wing. Again, Marble Fox. But okay, same again, get the Velcro. And if you see how that opens up. Nearly takes all the tangles out. Makes the fly much more mobile. And then just got to sort of come in, measure it up. That there. 1, 2, 3. 3 tons will hold just about any material, especially like your soft natural fuzz like this. Just get that, will hold them just nice. And I'll come in and snip that nice and close. That looks quite good. And if you are, I mean, there's no harm whatsoever if you just want to got a wee spot of cement there just in the butts before you completely cover them up, just to help bind the thread to the, or bond the thread to the hair, just for a bit of security. It'll not go anywhere anyway. Then I'm going to take just a wee bit of, just to add a little bit extra flash to this. A couple of strands of peacock crystal flash. You don't want too much, you know, it can be a bit it can be a bit much, you know, you can overpower them with the flash if you're not careful. So just tie that in, sort of fibres on each side, a couple of turns. Fold it back. Another couple. And there you go. Just a wee bit of flash, just to lift it a wee bit. And the last thing is just a bit of jungle cock. Just pick a couple of nails here. Oops, just broken that. Still tie it in. I like the jungle cock to be quite short on this pattern. Others will tie it longer. Like here's a, if you look here, there's a wee sort of Patagorva variant tied on it, and I've left the jungle cock a wee bit longer. You couldn't see that there probably. Bigger. And I snapped the feather there, but it's alright, I can still push it back, fold it over. Right, that just adds some security. Never ever going to pull away. You know, the feather actually has to snap for that to come out. Which makes a difference, you know, just adds a bit of durability to your fly. And just, it's up to you. Some people like to tie them on together at the same time. I like to just do one at a time. Look at them from the front. Make sure it's sitting nice. From the top, make sure they're the same length. Same again, fold that back. old Hinton back. And then just keep your thread tight. Snap that away. That's basically the tie-in done. Just to finish this off. Got a wee drop of super glue. Run it in the thread. There we go. Let that set for a couple of seconds. You can just snip your thread away. You don't need to worry, right? If you're tying these flies, you're going to varnish, you know, it's super glued and then varnished several times. It's fine, you know, it's not going anywhere. You know, the salmon flies are swung. They're not taking the pounding it's that some other flies might get. But I would never do this with a bonefish fly. I'd always want to finish them. So I'm just going to come in with my... I've trimmed the tube just a couple of mil in front of the head, and I'm just going to bond it back. And that finishes it off. Now that the super glue is definitely set, I'll just come in. Just come in with some head cement. I'll give this the first coat of at least three, you know. And there you have it, a simple Shumakoff tube. They're nice wee tubes. Just, I mean, classic sort of Stoat's Tail, black wee bit of yellow. You can tie these in a range of sizes, a range of colours, patterns. So I hope you enjoyed that. Something a bit different for my channel, I suppose. That's mostly been saltwater flies so far. Maybe do a few more. So if you liked that, don't forget to give us a thumbs up below and subscribe for more HD videos. Also feel free to leave any comments, tell me what you like me to tie. Thanks for watching. Bye.